What is going on, everyone? I want to thank you so much for stopping by my channel. I'm Tavius Blaze, and today I'm bringing you the top 4 predictions for Destiny 2 The Witch Queen, which is now delayed until 2022. I am so excited for this expansion. I did some research, I watched Lord Daddy Bive. So if you enjoyed this video, go ahead and drop a like, subscribe, you know, the YouTube algorithm. Also, go ahead and drop in the comments what are your predictions. Let's just get into the video. The Witch Queen is the next big expansion for Destiny 2 after 2020's Beyond Light, which introduced our first Darkness subclass, Stasis. Now, I have done a decent amount of research both in-game and on the interwebs. I've read lore tabs, and I have narrowed it down to the 4 things that have a really high chance of actually happening when the Witch Queen releases in 2022. For our first prediction, yep, you guessed it, it's the new Poison subclass. It's almost a given that a new Darkness subclass will be introduced with the Witch Queen, and Poison, Corruption, Decay, whatever Bungie decides to call it, makes so much sense, especially after the new Warlock exotic gauntlets we got with Beyond Light, the Necrotic Grip. Poison has been in the game for years since the hand cannon Thorn was introduced, and with Necrotic Grip releasing and the lore that came with it, it shows that Bungie isn't done with poison, corruption kind of abilities, and it would fit perfectly with the Darkness Hive Savathun expansion. Now, I'm not gonna go deep into the lore of the Thorn of the Necrotic Grip, I'll leave that for Bive or Mylin, but I'm really excited for the possibility of having poison in the game. Maybe even necromancy, imagine taking over a thrall or a vandal to help you in battle, that would be awesome. Okay. Time for number 2. In number 2 we have, of course, a new destination. Destiny has always been adding new planets and areas to explore with every major expansion, but which area could that be? Good old Chicago. Yes, everything is pointing towards old Chicago. The old Chicago we've been hearing about for quite a few years now. It's possible that old Chicago assets were built years ago but scrapped and never made it into the final game, similar to Europa. And the Witch Queen could be its debut. Looking through concept art for Old Chicago, the swamps and rain has me so excited. Bungie showed us what they can do with weather, adding snowstorms to Europa. So if they bring us Old Chicago with their swamps and rain, sign me up. Now, I believe there's a big chance that the EDZ will be vaulted, since it's old Red War content and not even New Light players really use it. Also, the Hawkmoon quest will go away by Witch Queen's release. And since Bungie recently came out and said that we will not be getting the Plaguelands added to the Cosmodrome, there is definitely room to add another Earth destination. Okay, coming in at number 3, we have a returning zone. The Dreadnought. Yes, I know Bungie said in the past that it wasn't coming back, but I still believe it will. The Dreadnought is one of my favorite destinations of the entire Destiny franchise, and I feel like Bungie announcing that they've taken more time with the Witch Queen and we are not getting the Plaguelands, maybe that means they need a little more time to enhance the Dreadnought, they can take away EDZ and bring us Old Chicago. We are going to need a very Hive destination, and I hope Savathun being the Taken Queen will bring us the Dreadnought. Which brings us to the final prediction, number 4. King's Fall Raid is coming back. Yes, I said it, putting it out into the universe. With how much hype there is around Vault of Glass, and Bungie seemingly going to one raid per big expansion, I guess I should say one new raid per big expansion, and one comes out of the vault. It would make so much sense if they bring back the Dreadnought and then the King's Fall raid for Fall 2022. That would give us the Witch Queen raid for the spring of 2022, and then the King's Fall raid for the fall of 2022.
My scan says the runes draw energy from those tunnels. If you get me over there, I can hack them and open the door.
I really hope you enjoyed this video. I had so much fun making it. There are so many predictions out in the wild, but I had to narrow it down to the four most likely to happen. Don't forget to drop a like, and I'll see you on the next one. Peace.